Steve Dotto here. When Apple released iOS 6 and they revealed to the world Siri, this intelligent voice recognition assistant, a lot of us got really excited about the potential of what Siri might represent to us. And indeed, a lot of Siri's potential has become a reality. I use Siri on a regular basis now for sending texts. I very seldom type a text in anymore. I use it for email on my phone. I use it for doing searches, asking it where things are. But none of those things have really changed the way that I do things. They're more convenient now because I do it my voice instead of having to look down at the phone. But they haven't really changed anything. The thing that has changed for me with Siri is ideas, how I remember things. Like all of us, when our mind is relaxed, when we're driving somewhere, when we're out for a walk, we remember the things that we have to do, or we come up with great ideas. Some of us do it in our sleep, and then we write down on a notepad beside our bed, and then, of course, we wake up in the morning, and we realize that that was not a good idea. But typically speaking, when you're walking or driving, and you come up with a good idea, it is a good idea, or it's something that is important. There's no convenient way to capture that. Some people make a phone call to themselves and leave a voicemail message, which I always thought was kind of an awful lot of work for remembering something. Siri does a brilliant job of setting reminders, and it does it in such a way that it will intelligently remind us when we need to know. Let me show you this, how this works. So I'm driving along in the car, and I remember, oh, finally, I got to get the dog's hair cut. So I enable Siri. Remind me when I get home to call the groomers and make an appointment for Farley. I was a little long-winded. Let's see.
Here's your reminder for when you get home.
That's fantastic.
Shall I create it?
Yes, you shall. I will confirm that. And now Farley will get his haircut.
I'll remind you.
Thank you. Don't interrupt anymore. That is brilliant. So now, because I have location services installed or enabled on my iPhone, as I pull into my driveway, Siri will let me know. And let me show you. This is an important step that you have to do. You have to go in to your settings and into your privacy settings within your iPhone, and you have to enable location services and turn them on, and then you have to select which of the applications can access location services. Now, this is an important privacy issue, and also battery life issue as well. This, you have to tell which applications can actually know where you are physically at any time. And so if I've turned that on in Siri, which I have down here, we go down to get down to Siri, we see it's turned on. Now Siri will let me know when I'm coming, pulling into the driveway. So as I drive into my driveway, Siri will bing, or sorry, reminders will bing, and it'll go, remember to call the groomers. And when I sit down at my computer, that will sync with my desktop computer, and the reminder will come up on my desktop as well. It is a spectacular way to organize yourself better. And you don't have to say when I get home. We can also do the same thing at Siri. Remind me at 4 p.m. to go shopping. I don't know why I'd do that.
Here's your reminder for tomorrow at 4 p.m.
Perfect.
Shall I create it?
No, I think I'm going to pass on that because it's really not that
okay,
good a message. Yes, okay.
Don't.
Thank you very much. I should point out that it said tomorrow at 4 p.m. because it's after 4 p.m. on the day that I'm recording this. If it had been, I'd been recording at 9 in the morning and I'd said, remind me at 4 p.m., it would have said 4 p.m. today. Using Siri for these sorts of internal messages or personal messages and reminders is a tremendous way of taking advantage of the technology and keeping ourselves that much more efficient. I hope that you found this little video useful today. If you have, please give us some props, give us a like, and don't forget you can also certainly sign up and here on YouTube and subscribe to get all of our dottotech videos. We do about one a week. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks so much for spending time with me today.